In a bid to revamp the railway transport in the country, the government of Uganda recently obtained a loan of 1 trillion shillings to renovate the existing meter gauge railway line. According to the Minister of Works and Transport, renovation works are underway along Mukono-Kampala railway lines.
Now, this is a project which is 19.8 million euros. The financing is coming from the Spanish government, a Spanish loan. And so far, works are at about 20%. It is expected to be completed in February 2024. And the works involve mainly rehabilitation of the line by replacing steel sleepers with concrete sleepers. And we are also going to replace the old rails with the new rails, which have been imported from Spain. And they have already been delivered on site.
Mwebaze notes that whereas the old line was still functional, they decided to replace it with concrete rail sleepers as a means of fighting vandalism of the railway installations.
The main output is that the speed restriction will be reduced. In other words, the trains will be able to move a bit faster. Two, the accidents will drastically reduce. Three, the vandalism will stop, because nobody can steal concrete sleeper.
The ministry has also procured new locomotives, wagons, as well as coaches as a means of improving the railway transport. And very soon, Uganda Railway Corporation is expected to resume the passenger commuter services between Kampala and Mukono.
The government is planning to procure new locomotives, about 11 of them. We are procuring new wagons, new passenger coaches to rehabilitate the old wagons, and also we are going to procure two new wagon ferries, which will be able to move from Port Bear to Mwanza, and also from Port Bear to Kisumu.
Efforts are also underway to kickstart the construction of a standard gauge railway line to match the international standards. It is anticipated that once complete, the standard gauge railway will improve cargo transportation, not only in Uganda, but across the continent.
There is business for both systems, and both systems can complement each other, like in Kenya and Tanzania, how they've done it. We cannot have only one system, yeah, because both of them can serve, because they have their specific pros.
Railway is perceived by passengers as a safer and more affordable mode of transport than road. But in Uganda, over 90% of the traffic along the northern corridor is carried by road, with a mere 7% moving by rail because of poor infrastructure. Subsequently, transport costs along the corridor are relatively high.
Just to get in Kampala, but here I only take only 40 minutes. Yet the fares are also fair, let me say. 1.5 as compared to 2.5. A difference of 1,000 shillings.
The current railway line was constructed over a century ago by colonial masters as they sought to ease the transportation of cash crops from the landlocked Uganda to the seaport at Mombasa. Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.